everyone, and welcome to Heath Street Baptist Church for our last lunchtime concert of the year. Thank you for those who turned out here, and also for those watching online. For those of you in the room, if you could switch off your phones, etc., and alarms, that'd be great. Just a couple notices. Next year, we have a bit of uncertainty with regards to lunchtime concerts because we're going to have building work starting up in February, which is going to be the facade at the front, and we're probably going to cancel all the lunchtime concerts during that period of time, or should I say, move them to evening concerts, just because of the uncertainties with the noise and things like that. Come and talk to me at the end if you'd like to know more about that, and there is some fundraising going on if anyone feels generous. There's no lunchtime concerts in January, as per our usual schedule, but there is one on the 21st of January, as long as the government doesn't intervene, that is. But without further ado, I'd like to welcome Ensemble Molière and hopefully have a wonderful concert. Thank you.
Thank you. styles, as pioneered by François Couperin and developed by Georg Telemann. This reunion de goût, or reunion of taste, was an idea promoted by Couperin, and in 1726 he published Les Nations, which was a collection of pieces celebrating national style. They had previously been published under different names, and then Couperin reworked them and retitled them to more suit this new theme of his. The collection consists of La Francoise, L'Espagnol, and La Piedmontaise. And the piece that we're going to play next in the programme, the slightly more ambiguously titled L'Imperiale, which is probably the most Italian in style of these suites, although still very French.
Thank you. Paris Quartets in E minor next. Telemann wrote and published two sets of quartets, 12 in total, for flute, violin, gambo, and basso continuo, published in 1730 and 1737. And in 1730, he was invited to Paris by musicians and composers, including Bravet, the flautist, Guignon, the violinist, and the gambist, Goffogre. Back then, there were more freer to go to you know, other countries than us, possibly. The first set was like a souvenir to them because he was invited, and then, okay, why not compose a piece for them? And then I can play along with them. So, and the pieces represented Italian, German, and French style, as Alice explained. So he follows sort of what Couperin started, this Réunion de goûts. And today we're playing the E minor quartet from the second set, which was published in 1737 when Telemann eventually arrived in Paris. So he, in the first 7 years, he couldn't really get there, but in 1737, he eventually got there. And they played all 12 quartets with the musicians in Paris, and you can tell they were really fantastic players, as some of the movements requires a virtuosic technique. You can hear soon. Also, three parts were written equally, quite equally, flutes, violin, and gamba. And it's written as a suite, which is a typical French style, starting with a long prelude, followed by five different dance movements. And this piece is ending with a rather quite emotional chaconne, salabande-like ground bass movement.
Thank you. and it's an arrangement of music by Marc-Antoine Charpentier. He was one of the composers who worked with our namesake Molière. In fact, right at the end of Molière's life, he wrote three pretty well-known sets of music to plays. One of them you probably have heard of if you know of Molière, the Le Malade Imaginaire, which was the last play that Molière played himself before he died. The other two plays are Le Mariage Forcé and La Comtesse d'Escarbagne. And we've got the overture from the second one, La Comtesse d'Escarbagne, and some musical interludes, instrumental interludes from Le Mariage Forcé. In total, it's six movements and represents the French style very well. Hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
play for live audience when it's really uncertain situation. But thank you very much for coming. The last piece we're going to play is again from the Lenocion. This is the Passacaglia from La Flansoise. And we will have, because we became from 2 months ago, October, BBC New Generation Bach Ensemble, and we'll be on Radio 3 quite often. So if you'd like to get to know about when we're on radio and also another concerts and festival, please sign up to our mailing list. There is some sign up information at the door. And if anyone watching online, please visit our website, ensemblemolière.com. Thank you very much for watching and listening.
And we have CDs if you don't have any Christmas presents.